Howdy, folks, and welcome back to 50 Nautical Mile Arc. We have a special request flight today. So we are in Kamloops, Canada. At least I think it's pronounced Kamloops, maybe Conloops, I'm not sure. But we're at the airport there, Charlie Yankee Kilo Alpha. And we'll be flying over to either Cache Creek or Cache Creek. Not exactly sure how to pronounce that, but that is Charlie Alpha Zulu 5. And we will be doing a completely VFR flight today. There are no instruments or anything we can use to get there. So we're going to follow the lake. Actually, we're going to follow the Thompson River, which brings us to Kamloops Lake. And then there's another river. And then that takes us to the airport. However, we are going to detour a little bit and see how the city of Cache Creek is modeled. Because it's supposed to follow the map and train data. And if there's buildings on a map and roads on a map, the city should be there too. So we're going to check that out. That'll be kind of fun. And I have my sketch drawn out of the area. Of course, we can use a built-in map if we get lost. And that'll simulate an iPad on our lap. But hopefully we can do this without needing to pull that up. Anyway, we're in the Beaver today. And we'll see how this goes. My last flight with this Beaver, which you haven't seen yet because I'm uploading these out of order, had a nice flight but a terrible landing. So I don't think it can go worse. So hopefully we have a good flight today. Clear skies, it looks like. No haze or anything. So we should have good visibility as well. And this is a 3D modeled airport. Let's have a look at where we are. So we are at Kamloops or Kamloops Airport, and the city is over that way, so we're actually going to take off and go that direction before we turn around and go this direction to follow the river and the lake. And you see that road on the left on the side of the river? That would be Canada 1, or I don't know what they call their cross-country highways. And here in the United States, we call them like US 1. I don't know. It's just number 1. I don't know how to say it. But those of you who know the area can silently correct me, I guess. But this train looks gorgeous. I wasn't sure what to expect, but it's not mountainous, but it's more than just hills. So this is going to be a beautiful, beautiful flight. I am very excited. And we are going to get started here. Enough chit-chat. Let's hop inside and get this thing started up. All right, so this door we can close from here. This door, can we reach it? Yeah. There we go. And hop back up front. And first thing we're going to do is set our fuel. We don't need 2.5 hours of fuel. In fact, I don't know how much we even need. I think I measured this is 60 miles or so. 55 to 65 miles. Let's give ourselves 1.75 hours of fuel because we are going to do a little bit of detouring and we want extra. So that's what we'll do. I have to reset my controls here. All right, so first thing we're going to do is hide that yoke in the middle because that's in the way. We're going to turn on a tank, and we're going to pump this thing up so that the gauge in the middle gets to the green. Not sure if you can see that move in there. One more, and I think that's all we need there. Everybody buckled in and ready to go because we're going to get going here. Turn radios on right away. Let's get some lights going. Which ones do we want? I guess we can turn that one on too. Oh, don't need that one on. Where's my primer? There it is. Prime 3 times. And fuel and props full. Bring throttle up 1/4. Come back down here. And fuel boost and hold the starter for 4 seconds. And then both magnetos, ignition, and it, whoops. I haven't screwed this up in like 2 years. What did I do wrong? I got the gas. I got the pump. I got everything forward. Let's try that again. That's very strange. There we go. I guess I didn't have enough throttle. It's supposed to only need 1/4 throttle, but I had to go up 3/4. Anyway, not too concerned. 55 degrees. Actually, it probably is 55 degrees right now. No, it's 55 degrees in Minneapolis right now. It's probably, I don't know, what would that be, 30-something maybe up in Canada. All right, we are going to use 1 NDB. Just in case we get lost, I can head towards NDB, then go straight north. So we got to turn it on first, and then we need to get 236. Okay, it's going to be that one. Okay. And where's the really big one? Where is it? Well, give me a second to find the click point. Okay, I just spent like 5 minutes trying to get the right click point to make that first number a 2 when I cannot, so we'll just forget about that. That's really going to bother me. Have to figure that one out later. All right, well, since that's that, nothing else to do. No VORs or anything. So, I'm going to take off our runway 22. So let's hop outside. And runway 22 is over to the right. So parking brake. There we go. Whoa. Doesn't take any throttle to get going here. Let's turn all the way around and we're just going to go out left. And then we'll take off towards the southwest on runway 22 and then go over the city and have a look around. All right, and so we're going to be turning on our final taxiway. Try to get some views of the airport while we taxi here. Oh, I like how I can see the exhaust pipe corroded and rusted. I never realized that before. Nice small airport, although that intersecting runway is quite huge and long. So I would imagine you can land some good-sized airplanes here. Looks like we got more hangars over there. I didn't notice that before. All right, are we all clear? Looks like we're all clear. Let's hop inside. Oh, let's... Oh, dear, I can't see. That's okay. We should have figured it out. Whoops. Alright, where's our taxiway? There it is. Alright. I can't see anything. There we go. Flaps down once for takeoff. Or down twice, I guess. And away we go. Get ready. Watch the torque. This thing torques like crazy. I've got the rudders all the way to the right. And up we go. Only need a half a runway. Now we're still really torquing. Oh my gosh. First set of flaps in. Let's get our landing lights on since there we go. And we're turning. Which way we turn it? There we go. Landing lights on since we're going to be staying low. That banking, I'm not doing it all. That's just all the torque. There's Canada Highway 1 right there. Alright, we're gonna go up a couple thousand feet. We're not too high this time. In fact, let's stay low and bring in the flaps now. We'll level off and get some speed already. Bring in those props so they're in the green. Hear the sound change. Excellent. Everything else in the green? Oh yeah. Good. Make sure everything here is in the green, and it is. Alright, so here we go. There is the city of Kamloops, or Kamloops. Let's hop outside, actually. There we go. Alright. Airport, obviously. And the city, which is much, much less densely packed in the sim than I thought. Then again, I have my buildings turned down one level. So if my buildings were up all the way, all those roads you see would be full of buildings probably. But I just turned it down one level because normally you don't need everything up cranked. Well, that looks really cool in the distance where the river goes, but we're not going that way, so let's turn around. And if we look right, I think we'll be able to see downtown. Ooh, kind of windy. There we go, keep everything coordinated. good. There's downtown going under the nose there. You can tell because the map data and density for buildings is pretty accurate. Actually, let's go all the way out to the river. I have this written down as Thompson River, which turns into Kamloops Lake. All right. There we go. Bring the throttle a little bit. We're going kind of fast. I'm not going to go any higher. I like how we're below the surrounding terrain, though. That is so cool. So the city's like in a little valley here. That looks really nice. All right, let's check our temperatures. All right, green, green. Oh, we're in the red. Our cylinder temp, we're going to start on fire. Oh my. Why is that so high? Why is our temperature so high? Everything's in the blue up here. Huh. Well, we'll dial this back and cool it down a little bit. Don't want to have a fire. There we go. Already in the green. That was a close one. So we'll give it a little bit more throttle. Alright. Again, well below the train. Looks like we've got some lakes up there. And we're entering Kamloops Lake right now. And there's a look back at the city and the airport. Let's see if that makes a great screenshot. Very nice. Except I better hop in and fly this thing. Alright, good. Temperatures are way down. I can speed back up again. That was startling. There you go. 140 miles an hour or so. We'll keep it at that. And it's just pretty much a 60 or so mile trip down this lake and the river. So I guess we're just not much to talk about, I guess. So we're just going to do some sightseeing until we get closer, and then I'll describe what we see based on what I jotted down here. So I'll just fly this plane and you enjoy the scenery, and I'll catch you in a little bit. Alright, we're about at the end of Kamloops Lake, and if you look right where the lake turns into the river, you can see where Canada Highway 1 crosses the river. And then we have the Snaky River going around and back and forth. And then we got to start paying attention because, like I said, there's no instruments, no radios or anything. We just have to pay attention. Plus, we're below the surrounding terrain, so we got to be really careful. Not sure how that's going to affect us when we get to Cache Creek. Because, like I said, I want to go to the city as well before we go to the airport. The airport is quite a way south, near a place called Boston Flats. So we have to go north of the airport to get to the city. But if you look on the horizon, I see an ominous large hill that we might have to worry about. Or maybe we're not quite going that far. I'm not sure. Just keeping an eye on my temperatures. Plenty of fuel. Green, green, and green. Come up here, everything in the green. Nice, nice scenery, though. I have to be honest, I cannot remember if I have version 3 mesh for this area. I'm pretty sure this is version 3 mesh because that other lake, Okanagan, I already forgot what it's called, but that was version 3 mesh and this isn't too far from there, so I'm pretty sure this is version 3. Just keeping an eye on the surrounding terrain, make sure we don't gradually drift too close. Reminds me of being allowed to drive my uncle's pontoon boat as a kid. I would kind of drift towards shore and not realize it. There's a nice little valley there. But yeah, what a beautiful area. This must be just incredible in real life. Anything that's amazing in the sim has to be just extraordinary in real life. So I wrote down on my little chart here, we have to navigate around a couple hills, but I didn't realize this whole area is full of hills. So I don't know exactly which hill we're going to keep track of, but I know the river turns to the south around the part of the airport, so we'll just keep an eye on that. Because which way are we heading now? We're pretty much due west. So pretty sure we're not anywhere close yet because that river has to go to the left and then we got those hills in front of us. And I have a feeling I'm going to have to pull out the built-in map, the VFR map, because like I said, I know people think that's cheating to pull up the in-sim map, but in real life, this day and age, we would have laptops on our or iPads on our lap with real-time GPS marking our position. It's not just a map, but actually marking our position. So I don't feel so badly about pulling up the in-sim map, although I like to try to do as much as I can without it. And we are cooking along pretty well. I think we're doing about 160 miles an hour, so even though it seems like we're just floating along, that's not much time to make decisions. But this sure looks nice. And I really, really enjoy flying below the terrain. That's one of my favorite things to do, is to fly lower than your surrounding terrain. And that's how they would fly these, you know, bush planes anyway. Alright, I better check my temperatures. Alright, we're still good. I'm gonna have to switch fuel tanks soon here. Alright, well that looks like the bend to the left. So one of these hills is Elephant Hill. Is it the one off the nose, slightly to the right? Is that Elephant Hill? I do not know, but it's the biggest one around, so it must be. So I'm guessing if we take this river to the left a little bit, the airport, I'm guessing, is over here. Get the binoculars out here. I'm not sure. I just know I'm getting really dizzy from that, making me nauseous. But there's the highway in front of us, and I think that valley in front of us is going to go to the city. So let's go that way a bit. No, I think the city might be more to the right. Well, let's just go this way and then we'll get our bearings in a moment. Checking our temperatures, everything's good. I have to remember to switch fuel tanks soon. I hope I have enough fuel. This might be a longer flight than I thought. Let's hop outside while we can. So it's interesting how quickly we covered this river, because it seemed like it was going so slowly, but not really. Like I said, when we're going this fast, it seems like we're floating along, but you gotta pay attention because things come up more quickly than you realize, especially this terrain if we were to drift off. Let's take a screenshot of that too. Actually, maybe the airport is in front of us. Let's see, there's the river. Okay, so there's the river. There's where it turns left. The airport is straight off the river, but not too far. There's just one little hill in front of it. I don't think it's over there. It's hard to find airports in the hills because they can be behind a hill and you don't see it. I don't know, we'll look in a minute. Alright, I'm going to switch fuel tanks now because I'm getting nervous. Let's do the front. Was that what I wanted? Front, yeah. Okay. And temperatures while I'm at it. Still in the green. Everything's in the green. Alright, well. Still don't see an airport. Let's take out our binoculars here. When I looked at this real-life image of this airport, there were no buildings, just a couple sheds, and I saw markings on the runway, so I imagine it's paved, but in the sim it might not be, it might just be dirt. Oh, there it is. Ta-da! And it's paved. Good! So, that's what it looked like in real life, except on the far right here, there were a couple sheds, maybe a small hangar. Alright, so we know where the airport is. That means I am going the right way to the city. So, according to my chart then, this would be Elephant Hill right here. Let's go outside so the people who know the area can actually look at it. So, if there's the airport, according to my diagram, this would be Elephant Hill. Right there. I could be wrong, but I don't see any other large hills around. I guess that could be it, maybe, but I don't think so. There's my airport. I'm pretty sure this is it. There's a highway there for reference, I guess, for those of you who know the area. And yeah, I guess it's a park, a provincial park, which for us would be a state park in the U.S. So, I don't think the airport's in the right spot, because I see, if you look down under the airplane, you see a little tiny city there. That looks like the shape of the Boston Flats. Doesn't look big enough to be Cache Creek, but maybe it is. If it is, there it is. Seems kind of close to that airport, though. Then again, we're like 6,000 feet up, so maybe that is the city. I don't see any other cities up here. So yeah, I guess that must be it. Because there's the highway there. So then that would mean then that is Elephant Hill. That one, not that. This one, right there, under the tail. That would be Elephant Hill then. Yep, that makes more sense if I look at the airport, the hill. So that's Elephant Hill. And there's the city, and there's where the Canada Highway comes up and turns to the south. Okay, good. So there it is. That works. Now I gotta figure out I'm gonna turn around without getting into terrain. Well, let's look back at it one more time. Looking back to the east, there's the airport. and it's time to fly a plane. We're 7,000 feet. I was pretty close. I said 6,000. I'm bringing back the throttle. It feels like we're not even moving. What does that look like? That's awesome. We have a long ways to go here. I better pull up. Trying to keep it as realistic as possible, though. Now we want to land towards the north. We want to land on runway 33. Because if there's any wind, when I looked at the weather, it's coming from the north, so we're going to want to turn around. So we need to keep our altitude to turn around, then we need to actually turn around. So this will be fun. Well, that's a nice shot. That looks really cool looking back. Cool. So looking at my timer here, that was about a 24-minute flight or so, although we haven't landed yet. Now, if we were going straight to the airport and not sightseeing, we would have approached completely differently, and we'd already be on the ground. Let's have a look at our vitals here. Looking good. There you go, to the south. Looking back at the city. There's one thing I've learned about Flight Simulator is that things that look far in a map when you're up in the air are much closer than you think. But I was able to find the airport without using the built-in maps. I'm pretty happy about that. Gotta be careful of this terrain here. I think all our lights are on, everything we need. That on. Vital's still looking good. Yeah, we don't have anything to worry about. We're coming down anyway. I'm just going to go out here to the right. That's a nice crest of a hill there. The road on top. We're going to make a sharp U-turn, avoiding that hill in front of us and the one we're about to go over. And then we're going to relocate the airport and try to land. And as long as I don't crash the plane, that means I did better than my previous landing. Well, I didn't crash in the last one, and you'll see that video. That video's coming up later, but I didn't crash, but it bounced several times, and yeah, it was bad. Can't get much worse. Bringing back the throttle so we can have a steep descent without gaining too much speed. Oh, that looks so nice. Again, we're going 120 miles an hour, so that hill in front of us is going to come up way sooner than it looks. So let's have a nice deep bank. Give it a little bit of throttle. To go yet here. I came down too low, didn't I? Now I can't even see where we are. See, that's the problem. I told you we'd have to relocate the airport. Is that it? I seriously lost the airport. Well, there it is. I see it. Right up there. With like a barn right in the middle of the highway. How funny is that? That's the tree lines and farms add-on I have freeware. Alrighty, now that we know where we are, props forward, throttle down so we can gain speed. And look at this wind coming off the ridges. It's really killing us here. But now we're definitely lower than the surrounding terrain. Look at that. But even on this side, that's awesome. Okay. Time to land the plane. That's why I have so many problems, because I'm always sightseeing until the last minute. And I believe that's Canada Highway 1 again. Elephant Hill right off the nose right now, I imagine. We're actually quite a bit higher than we look, aren't we? Alright, first set of flaps down, so we're going to float and bleed off speed. Second set of flaps, we're going to need a lot of throttle to stay alive here. We're going to float. And I will put down a third set of flaps in a moment. There's that hill. I like looking at that hill. That's cool. I'm sure it's a wonderful place to be. All right. Now we got a lot more runway than it looks like, so I don't have to land on the very end. I can take my time and hold off. Try to have a smooth landing. And third set of flaps. A little more throttle. We're going to float like crazy and bleed off speed. Tail draggers are so tough. You come down steep, then you level off. Well, don't want to bleed out that much speed. We're still higher than it looks. We're still quite a ways up. And pull back so we don't bounce. And I floated up. Maybe this is going to be worse than my last landing. I didn't think that was possible. And there we go. That was really bad. Shoot. Oh well. Oh well, don't ground loop though. Don't ground loop. I'm not even using my brakes. I'm just going to coast to a stop, get the flaps in. Oh, look out for the deer. Let's have a look out our window. Yeah, well. So I know I say this every time I fly this plane, but before the sensitivity on my yoke reset, I was actually able to land this thing perfectly every single time. And then X-Plane updated itself, obviously, and then that reset all my calibration and it reset my sensitivity and all that stuff. So as an added challenge, I just left the sensitivity in default. But ever since, I have not been able to land this plane. So, that's okay. I'm not going to make a big deal out of it because once X-Plane 11 is out of beta, I'm going to have to refigure out everything anyway. So, I'll just accept the crappy landings for now. And I'll work it out once X-Plane 11 is released. At the time of this recording, it's in public beta 17, but I'm not going to bother with the betas. Let's just pull off here. Brakes, set the parking brake, and what can we do here? Turn off the ignition, kill fuel and props, turn off the gas tank, and what can we turn off? Turn off some of this stuff, and the radios that we didn't need, bring that back in, open up our doors. And oh yeah, to open up this one you have to actually go to the back. There we go. And static elements somewhere, pre-fed elements they call it. Let's hop outside. And there we are, safe and sound. So looking at the surrounding terrain, it just looks so nice. But anyway, it was a quick one today. Hope you enjoyed the flight. I hope I was able to make my research somewhat accurate in pointing out things. Ooh, look, we're on a big cliff. I love landing strips on a cliff. Look at this. I love that in like three directions. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the flight. I do prioritize requests over my other flights. I have a bunch of other flights pre-recorded and ready to go. I cannot remember which one comes next, but you'll see it when it uploads. And, if you are a regular subscriber, thank you for your continuing support. If you found my channel by accident, please subscribe. And leave a comment and share this with your friends. General aviation flights most of the time. Every once in a while, the 727 will make an appearance and we'll do a long haul. But general aviation, 99% of the time. And there you go, I guess. Not much else to say. And I'll catch you on the next one.